Hi everyone, welcome to our newest update for PowerDirector. This will be our final update for 2021, and we've got tons of exciting new things in store for you all. But before that, we'd like to send you a massive thank you for tuning in each month and showing us your support over the past year. Thank you. Let's move on to our exciting content update.
This month for PowerDirector app users, we're bringing you titles with sound effects, more stock content, and holiday exclusive transitions, overlays, and more. And for PowerDirector 365, we made some updates to our AI tools and also added AI support for motion tracking, plus new transitions and stickers for the upcoming holiday season. Let's dive right into the update. For our PowerDirector app users, we've added a bunch of new content this month, including new titles with sound effects. Eye-catching titles are crucial for attracting viewers, but what if you can keep your audience even more engaged with added sound effects, or 12 new unique and professionally designed title animations?
And also, get into the holiday spirit with some exclusive holiday content.
Send a holiday greeting or make a New Year's celebration video with new overlays and stickers.
Make sure to update your app to the latest version to check out these holiday exclusives. Moving on to updates for PowerDirector 365. For users with NVIDIA graphic card, we've added the option of AI audio denoise, video denoise, and de-reverb with NVIDIA broadcast support. On top of that, there's also AI motion tracking, so you can add text or graphics to automatically follow the motion of any object for more accurate results. Moreover, give your 2D and motion graphic titles a creative twist with the addition of 9 blend-in modes. Create unique titles that make your text stand out.
For new contents this month, turn your video project into Winter Wonderland with new snow transitions packed perfect for Christmas videos, New Year's projects, special events, holiday greeting videos, and so much more. Or bring some fun and creativity with 5 new sticker packs, including handwritten, tutorial, lightning, and special effects volume 1 and 2.
And now it's time for our Q&A. Let's kick off things with our first question from MarieLou3M. How can you create a green screen without actually using physically a green screen? That's a great question. You can create a green screen in both PowerDirector and ColorDirector. If you haven't tried out ColorDirector yet, click up top to download it. In the meantime, I'll show you how to create a green screen in PowerDirector for PC. Once you have your clip imported into PowerDirector, go to Tools and open Mask Designer. You'll need to mask the section that you want to apply the green screen to. Choose your mask shape, and if you have an irregular shape, choose Create a Custom Selection Mask. Then move along the timeline, adjusting the mask as you go. Once masking is done, place a green color border on the editing track below, and your green screen video is now complete.
And next we've got a question from Pietro Ebner. Is it possible to load and import LUT cube files? Yes, you can. You can import LUT files and use them in the PC version. In PowerDirector, click on Effect Room on the left-hand side menu, then click on Import Color Presets and See LUTs up top. Import your cube file and it'll appear in the imported folder under Color LUT. In PowerDirector, you can import the following LUT file formats, then drag and drop to apply your imported LUT to your clip.
And lastly is a question from YouTube Epic. Do you guys have any tips for gaming videos editing? Sure we do. Let me give you a few tips on how to edit gameplay videos. For gaming videos, it's essential to keep your viewers engaged. Since your gameplay can last for hours, it is important to trim and edit your clips to showcase only the most exciting moments. Also, add titles and captions to highlight characters or events on top of your commentary. And to keep content visually interesting, add some impressive transitions and effects from time to time, but not so much that it becomes distracting. You can even record and add footage of yourself, such as a picture-in-picture effect, so the audience can see your reaction simultaneously. For more gaming editing tips, be sure to visit the CyberLink blog.
And that's it for our December What's New in FAQ. Let us know what you think about this month's updates or if you have any questions you'd like to ask us.
Also, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more editing tutorials and updates. See you guys in the next video.